Today we will be installing a Pathway 3G modular access system at this residence. The ramp system we will be installing is a solid surface with two line handrails and consists of two platforms and three ramp sections. The necessary tools you will need to install a Pathway 3G are a level, a tape measure, a rubber mallet, a power drill, a half inch socket, a half inch long socket, a quarter inch socket, a 3/8 inch socket, a 3/16 inch bit, as well as 3/16 and 5/32 inch Allen wrenches, which are both included in the hardware provided. Begin the installation by placing the platforms and ramps in their approximate positions. Then place the various handrails, brackets, legs, ramp hangers, feet, and hardware packages in the approximate areas they will be used and assembled in. Start with the upper end of the system and work your way to the final ramp section. In this case, we will start at the door with a platform and begin assembly. We begin by loosening all of the set screws on the platform using a drill with a 3/16 inch bit. Walk around to each corner of the platform and loosen the two outer set screws, which will be used to secure the legs in place. Loosen the inner set screw on the bottom side of the platform as well, which will be used to secure the vertical posts for the platform handrails later on. Stand the platform on its side and insert a leg into the inside of the corner pocket. Measure the length of the leg that you will need for the specific height of the platform with a tape measure and adjust the leg as needed. Tighten both of the outer set screws on the platform using a drill with a 3/16 inch bit to secure the leg in place. Attach a foot to the leg and tighten the thumb screw to secure the foot in place. The foot can be installed in different positions as needed. Repeat the process of inserting the leg and attaching the foot with the remainder of the corners for this platform and set the platform in its final position. Place a level on the platform and adjust the legs if necessary by loosening the outer set screws, adjusting the leg, then tightening the set screws to make sure the platform is completely level. Once the platform is in place, we will begin connecting the two ramps together that will attach to the first platform. Start this process by aligning the ends of both ramps and placing a center saddle bracket into the slot in the side rail where the two ramp ends meet. Then secure with four bolts and washers. Finger tighten all four bolts completely and repeat this process on the other side. Now, tighten all eight bolts completely using a drill with a half-inch socket. Now place one ramp handrail end bracket on each corner of the ramp run. The ramp handrail end brackets attach with one bolt and washer installed through the outermost hole of the bracket and into the outermost of the two threads of inserts on the end of the ramp. Finger tighten each bolt, then tighten completely using a drill with a half inch socket. We now move to the second platform of the system. Begin assembly by loosening all set screws, both inner and outer. Place, measure, and secure all four legs, also attaching and securing their associated feet. We will now place a set of ramp hangers on the first platform we assembled. These ramp hangers engage as a side rail of the platform to allow the ramp run to hang from them. Flip the ramp run over and place the end of the ramp run on the ramp hangers. Once the ramp run is resting on the hangers, slide both ramp hangers apart until they are against the ramp side rails. Both hangers should be as far apart as possible for greater stability and safety. Set the second platform in its final position and make sure it's level. Adjust the legs if it's not. Place a set of ramp hangers on the second platform and set the other end of the ramp run on the two ramp hangers. Again, slide both ramp hangers apart until they are against the ramp side rails. We will now begin the platform handrail assembly for the first platform. Loosen all four inner set screws on the top of the platform using a drill with a 3/16 inch bit. Each platform handrail section requires two vertical posts, two round tubes for the rails, and one curb section. The tubes and curb section have threaded inserts at bottom ends. Start on one side of the platform handrail section with the first vertical post, and pass a bolt and washer through the first and third holes in the vertical post and into the threaded inserts in the top and second rail. Do the same for the curb section in the bottommost hole in the vertical post. Move to the other side of the platform handrail section and pass a bolt and washer through the holes in the vertical post and into the threaded inserts for the two rails and curb section. Finger tighten all three bolts, then use a drill with a half-inch socket to tighten the three bolts on each side of the platform handrail section completely. Place this platform handrail section in place, inserting the vertical posts into the inside of the corner pockets. Repeat platform handrail section assembly and placement process for the other platform handrail section. Tighten each inner set screw on both the top of the platform and the bottom in each corner to secure the handrail sections in place. Use a drill with a 3/16 inch bit or a 3/16 inch Allen wrench, as the underneath can be a tight area to fit a drill in. We will now assemble and attach the U-channel support legs to each side of the ramp run. Start by placing the support leg inside of the foot and tighten the thumb screw to secure the foot to the support leg. Align the support leg with the middle set of two protruding bolts and screw a nut and washer on the top and bottom bolts. Finger tighten, then tighten completely using a drill with a half-inch long socket. Repeat this process on the other side of the ramp run. We will now install the second platform handrail sections. Start by loosening the inner set screw in each corner on the top of the platform. Assemble one platform handrail section by repeating the process used for the first platform handrail sections. Place the platform handrail section in place, inserting the vertical posts into the inside of the corner pockets of the second platform. You will only need one vertical post for the next platform handrail section, since the other side will attach to the existing vertical post from the already placed platform handrail section. Start with a vertical post and simply pass a bolt and washer through the first and third hole in the vertical post and into the threaded insert in the top and second rail. Do this for the curb section as well, through the bottommost hole of the vertical post. Place the handrail section in position, inserting the vertical post into the inside of the corner pocket. Use three sets of bolts and washers to secure the rails and curb section to the existing vertical post. Finger tighten all three bolts, then tighten them completely using a drill with a 1/2-inch socket. In order to secure the handrail sections in place, tighten each inner set screw on both the top of the platform and the bottom, in each of the three corners of the platform where vertical posts are. We can now move on to installing the ramp handrail sections. Start by placing the first section at the top of the ramp run. Make sure the set of protruding bolts from the ramp connector bracket and the set of protruding bolts from the ramp end bracket passes through the bottom two holes of each ramp handrail post. Use four sets of washers and nuts with the two protruding bolts from the ramp connector and the two protruding bolts from the ramp end bracket to secure the two ramp handrail posts in place. In places where two ramp handrail sections are needed, they are joined with a plastic connector. Repeat the ramp handrail section installation process with a connecting ramp handrail section. Then, repeat the ramp handrail section installation process along with inserting a plastic connector on the other side of the ramp run. Make sure there is 1.5 inches space between the vertical post on the platform and the top handrail of the ramp handrail section. Now we move on to the final ramp section of the system. Begin by placing one ramp handrail end bracket on each corner of the ramp and secure each with one bolt and washer through the outermost hole of the bracket and into the outermost of the two threads of inserts on the end of the ramp. Place two ramp hangers on the second platform. Flip the ramp section over and set the ramp on the hangers. Slide both ramp hangers apart until they are against the ramp side rails. At the lower end of the system where the ramp meets the ground, we install a ground transition ramp. The two sections engage by simply sliding the first section that connects to the ramp into the channel of the section that will complete the end of the ramp system. The two sections are held in place by two screws, which are driven into the rounded connections on each side using a drill with a 1/4-inch socket. Connect the ground transition ramp to the end of the ramp section by lifting the ramp section and inserting the lip of the ground transition into the channel of the ramp. Install the final set of ramp handrail sections using the same process as all of the other ramp handrail sections. Again, make sure there is an inch and a half space between the vertical posts on the platform and the top handrail of the ramp handrail section. If there is too much or too little space, adjust the ramp as needed. Now we will assemble the closure kit for the first platform. Start by unscrewing the bolt that secures the second rail of the ramp handrail section. Place a tab with its short end against the ramp handrail post. Secure the tab to the ramp handrail post by placing the bolt with its washer through the tab and into the threaded insert in the second rail of the ramp handrail section. Then, disassemble an elbow. Unscrew the screw that connects the two ends of the elbow together with the 3/16 inch Allen wrench. Set the screw and nut aside, remove the center insert, and pull the elbow halves apart. Place one elbow half into the top rail of the ramp handrail section and secure the internal set screw with a 5/32 inch Allen wrench. And insert the other half of the elbow into the other end of the cut tube. Bring the elbow halves together and push the center insert into place. Put the screw through the top of the elbow and the nut on the bottom. Hold the nut in place while tightening the screw with a 3/16 inch Allen wrench. Bring the tube around and insert a bolt and washer into the top hole in the vertical post and through the threaded insert in the tube. Secure one end of the cut tube to the tab by passing a bolt and washer through the tab and into the threaded insert in the cut tube. Finger tighten this bolt. Secure the other end of the cut tube to the vertical post by passing a bolt and washer through the third hole in the vertical post and into the threaded insert in the cut tube. Finger tighten this bolt, then tighten both sides of the tube completely using a drill with a 1/2 inch socket. We will now begin assembling the closure kit for the second platform. Start by inserting a vertical post into the inside of the remaining corner pocket of the platform. As a helpful guide, make sure the bottom of the vertical post is flush with the bottom of the corner pocket so all holes will align. Tighten both inner set screws, the one on the top of the platform and the one on the bottom. Repeat the closure kit process that was completed on the first platform, on either side of the vertical post for the second platform. Thank you. Make sure to finger tighten all bolts during the process, then tighten all 6 bolts completely. We will now place and secure all handrail loops. Loops are used to finish the end of any handrail section not connected by closure kits. There are 2 types of loops, one for the top of a ramp handrail section and one for the bottom of the ramp handrail section. So make sure you are installing the correct loop. The loops used for the top of ramp handrail sections are slightly larger than the ones used for the bottom. You can verify this by standing them upright on the ground. The shorter loop is a bottom loop, and the taller loop is a top loop. Start with the top handrail loops. Slide the loop into the top rail of the ramp handrail section and align the tab with the ramp handrail section post. Secure with 1 self-tapping screw. Repeat this process for all top handrail loops as well as for all bottom handrail loops. We will now install protective caps on all exposed ramp side rails and the top of the vertical posts. Glue is supplied to secure these in place. Also, black caps on all ramp support legs and platform corner pockets are inserted now. Use a rubber mallet to secure them in place. B plugs can be ordered and inserted into a ramp handrail post to keep bees out. Simply push the plugs into each hole on each ramp handrail post. There are 4 different handrail options available that can be used with this modular access system. We will now show how to install horizontal pickets for a platform and ramp handrail section. When ordering horizontal pickets, you will receive a 2-line handrail and 5 additional tubes with threaded inserts at bottom ends already inserted for each ramp handrail section. For each platform handrail section, you will receive a 2-line handrail with a curb section and 4 additional tubes with threaded inserts at bottom ends already inserted. You will insert these additional tubes utilizing the holes along the ramp handrail posts and the vertical posts. Make sure to finger tighten all bolts, then tighten them completely using a drill with a 1/2-inch socket when handrail section is complete. Thank you. Now we will show you how to install vertical pickets for our platform and ramp handrail section. When ordering vertical pickets, you will receive a single line handrail with vertical picket insert already assembled. You would then simply attach each ramp and platform handrail section to the system. But if you order any other handrail option and later wanted to switch to vertical pickets, a vertical picket insert can be ordered and assembled using just a few bolts per handrail section. Here we show how that's done. For platform handrail sections, leave the top rail and remove all other rails and the curb section. Simply bolt on the vertical picket insert with four sets of washers and bolts in the second and bottommost holes in the vertical posts. For the ramp handrail sections, remove any additional rails, then bolt on the vertical picket insert with four sets of bolts and washers in the first and bottommost hole in the ramp handrail posts. If a single line handrail is chosen for the system, you will receive a single line handrail with a curb section for each platform handrail section and a single line handrail for each ramp handrail section. This handrail option is installed just like the two line handrail would be, minus the second rail. There are three different surface options available that can be used with this modular access system. They are solid, expanded metal, and perforated, which are installed the same way the solid surface was just shown. The Pathway 3G modular access system is truly the most versatile and feature-rich ramp system with complete interchangeability.